Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to talk about knowing the stages of your customer journey. I have divided the video into two halves so that the video is not very big and lengthy. Now let us begin. We are going to talk about the different stages in the journey of a buyer. Now the journey from a complete stranger to the brand advocate will not happen overnight. Rather, you can move the prospects gradually or subtly from one stage of the relationship to another. Now, when you started your ideal customer journey, you found out all the bottlenecks that would restrict the journey from prospect to lead, from lead to customer, and from customer to brand advocate. Now, every customer has a different journey. And every step of the journey will involve different set of behaviors. Therefore, knowing each stage of your customer journey helps your audience progress. The content for each journey is therefore going to be different and will help create a seamless journey from a complete stranger to the brand advocate. Now let us discuss the steps. Step number one is your creating awareness. At this stage, your customer has no idea of your existence, your products or your services, even your brand, or what kind of a solution do you provide. The only thing that they are aware of are their pain points or the challenges that they have faced. For example, if your mobile phone is old, you require a new phone with probably a good brand name. Hence, it is very important to generate awareness and let your ideal customer know what solutions are you providing for their problems, and simply attract your target audience. How? Advertising, online or offline, is the most reliable way of generating awareness. Number two, social media sites, where billions of users are using multiple sites, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, etc. to get the information. Number three, search marketing, which can be done in different sites such as Google, Bing, to generate traffic for your business. Now, once your ideal customer is aware of your brand, the products or the services, it is essential to engage them constantly and capture their attention. In case of digital marketing, a valuable and informative content can be made available in different blogs, podcasts, videos. Here, the content must create interest and engage the audience by connecting their pain points with your solutions. For example, a video says, build your income funnel with the most profitable strategy in the stock market, or a video claiming, must have toys for baby cognitive development. Now such blogs, articles, videos would engage customers for comparably more time. Some may engage for a year before moving to the next stage of the journey, while there will be some customers who will be in the multiple stages of the customer journey within few minutes. Now step number three is building subscribers. Because it is digital marketing, building subscribers is very important. Hence, moving this ideal customer from an aware and engaged state to now as a lead is very essential. Here, at this stage, your customer is connected to your brand and somewhere puts your brand as a solution to their pain points or the challenge. At this very stage, it is very important to build trust because they need assurance to progress in the customer journey. Therefore, you need to provide hub content which increases the learning and expectations by producing content that aligns their personal values with yours. Now, normally, digital marketers, they create various subscribers by connecting to various sites and attract subscribers from podcasts, webinar registrations, subscription content, videos, etc. Thus, email marketing over here has been proven to be the cheapest and the highest converting method of moving the prospects to different stages of their customer journey. Example, IKEA has built social media subscribers on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, acquiring email subscribers. Websites that ask for email option form shows that they use email marketing as a tool of digital marketing. Now, step four is increasing conversions. At this stage, it is sure that you have gained the trust and you stand amongst the top to provide solutions to their pain points. Hence, over here, the commitment of your prospects need to be elevated by asking a small amount of time or maybe small amount of money. For example, people use low money webinars, product demos, etc. Now I will cover the remaining 4 points in my next video.